In your chemistry lab, you will be expected to know how to interpret and graph data found from your experiments. You will also use these graphs to help you find missing information. In fact, a lot of your labs will require you to determine several unknowns. So let's review the anatomy of a graph. There are two axes, the x-axis, which is horizontal, and the y-axis, which is vertical. The x-axis is known as the independent variable because this is the variable you are able to control in an experiment, while the y-axis is known as the dependent variable because its change is dependent on the independent variable. For example, if we have temperature as our dependent variable and time as the independent variable, and we were boiling a substance, we are able to control how long we boil the substance, but the temperature is dependent on how much time we allow the substance to boil for. We would also see that the y and x axes will always be labeled and must show the unit of that measurement if possible. Next, there will always be a title that shows the y axis versus the x axis. The majority of your graphs will be linear, and you'll notice that your data points won't perfectly align to form a perfect line. This is why we use something known as the best fit line, which is a straight line that best approximates the given set of data points. This line may pass through some of the points, none of the points, or all of the points. This, of course, depends on your data. Luckily, most graphing software will create the best fit line for you. You may also see the best fit line referred to as the trend line. You will also need to understand how to interpret the equation of this line. So let's go over the equation of a line, which is y equals mx plus b, where m refers to the slope and b refers to the y-intercept. The y-intercept is a point found on the y-axis. The slope is the change of y over the change of x. Think of this as a rate. For example, if we had this graph that showed the x-axis as the volume and the y-axis as mass, then the slope would show the change in mass over the change in volume. In this example, the slope is actually our density, since the formula for density is mass divided by volume. The slope is very useful because it will help you determine any unknown values. If you needed to find the slope from two points, you would use this formula. Start with labeling your two points. The first point is x1 and y1. The second point is x2 and y2. We can plug in our labeled values into the formula and subtract first, then divide to get our slope. Typically in chemistry, you won't be asked to find the slope by hand. You would just use the coefficient in front of the x in your trend line. Note, always make sure that your graph has a title. Each axis is labeled with the units, the best fit line is shown, and the equation for your trend line is shown. Do this to avoid losing any points on your lab reports. There are some chemistry formulas that can be written to represent the equation of a line. Here's an example of this, where the ln of p is y, this portion is the slope, our x is what is in parentheses, and our y-intercept is this. Let's say you were asked to find the heat of vaporization, but only were given this data. This is where graphing and determining the equation of your trend line comes in. Since we said that y is equal to ln of p, which is your vapor pressure, and x is equal to 1 divided by t, which is the temperature, we first need to change each one of these values. All temperatures must be in this form where we will divide 1 by each temperature and we will take the ln of each vapor pressure. When we do this and have the correct values, we can graph this data and add a trend line. Now that we have our equation of the trend line, we can use this equation to find the heat of vaporization. Remember what each part of this equation actually refers to. If we are looking for the heat of vaporization, which is this, we can use the slope and set the slope equal to this entire term. Our slope would have the unit of Kelvin since the x-axis was referring to temperature. Next, R is a known constant, which is this value. We can plug this in and solve for the heat of vaporization by multiplying both sides by this value and these units cancel. Divide both sides by -1 to get the heat of vaporization by itself. The typical units are kilojoules, so we can divide by 1,000 to get our answer in the correct units. That was just one of the many different types of questions you will see that involve graphing. To see what other types of graphing questions chemistry covers, click the link in the description. Once you've completed all those practice problems, come back to this playlist to see the next video.